Hello everyone, my name is Mohammad Raihan from Aliya University. Today we will learn about cement. Cement. A cement is a binder, a substance used in construction that sets hardness and adheres to other materials, binding them together. Cement is a seldom used solely, but is used to bind sand and gravel together. Cement is used with fine aggregates to produce mortar for masonry, or with sand and gravel aggregates to produce concrete. Storage of cement. Cement, being highly hygroscopic in nature, has to be protected from dampness during packing. Transportation and storage. Strength of concrete prepared with cement stored for longer period gets affected adversely with 3 month long stored cement. There is a 20% reduced in strength of concrete there's where cement is stored for 2 years. The 20-day concrete strength reduced by 50%. Hence, cement which has deteriorated during storage for longer periods should be tested in a laboratory before use. Composition of cement. Lime CaO 60 to 65%, silica ClO2 20% to 25%, aluminia 4 to 8%, iron oxide 2 to 4%, magnesium oxide 1 to 3%, sulfur trioxide 1 to 8%, alkalis 0.3% to 1%. Functions of ingredients. 1. Lime. Lime is the important ingredient of cement, and its proportion is to be maintained carefully. Lime is excess make the cement unsound and causes the cement to expand it. On the other hand, if lime is in deficiency, the strength of the cement is decreased and it causes cement to set quickly. Silica. This also an important ingredient of cement, and it gives or impact quick setting property to impart strength to cement. Alumina. The ingredient impart quick setting properly to cement. Express alumina weakness of the cement. Calcium sulfate. This ingredient is in the form of gypsum, and it functions is the to increase the interstitial settings time of cement. Magnesia. The small amount of the this ingredient impart hardness and color to cement. Sulfur. A very small amount of sulfur is useful to making sound cement. If it is in excess, it causes the cement to become unsound. Alkalis. Most of the alkalis present in raw material are carried away by the flue gases during heating, and a small quantity will be left. If they are excess in cement, effluence is caused.
Bogs.
Compound. When water is added in the cement, it reacts with it chemically and lead to formation of complex compound termed as bogues compound, which different properties to cement. Compound chemical formula, verted designation percentage by mass. Tricalcium silicate. Tricalcium silicate 20 to 50%, dicalcium silicate 20 to 45%, tricalcium aluminate 5 to 12%, tetracalcium fluorate 5 to 12%. Lime silica and iron oxide contribute towards strength, whereas alumina impart quick setting property. Magnesium oxide, when present in small amount, add hardness and color to cement. A very small amount of sulfate is useful in producing sound cement. 5. Both magnesia and sulfur are harmful if present in excess. Similarly, excess alkalis cause effluences. Formation of this compound in cement is not formation of this compound in cement is not simultaneous. Tricalcium aluminate. The cement is responsible for maximum development of heat of hydration. Tetracalcium aluminophorate. It is also formed within 24 hours of add of the water in the cement, and it's responsible for heat of hydration in the early ages of the cement, which is subsequently goes on decreasing with time. 3 is tricalcium silicate. It is formed within a week after the add of water in the cement. It responsible for strength to cement in its early age. 4. Dicalcium silicate. This compound forms very slowly and take about a year or so for its formation after the addition of water in the cement, and is responsible for progressive strength of the cement in the later stage. Heat hydration of cement. The heat of hydration is the heat generated when water and Portland cement react. Heat of hydration is most influenced by the proportion of C3H and C3A in cement, but it also influenced by water cement ratio, fierceness and curing temperature. As each one of these factors is increased, heat of hydration increases. Manufacturing of cement. There are two methods of manufacturing of cement. One, dry process. Second is wet process. Dry process. The both calcareous and argillaceous raw material are firstly crushed in the rotatory crusher to get 2 to 5 semi size pieces separately. The crushed material are again grinded to get fine particle into ball or tube mill. Each finely grinded material is stored in hopper after skinning. Now these powdered material are mixed in quite proportion to get dry raw mix, which is then stored in soils and kept ready to be sent into rotary kiln. Now the raw material are mixed in specific proportion so that the average composition of the final product is maintained properly. Wet process. The raw materials are firstly crushed and made into powder form and stored in silos. The clay is then washed and washing mills are to remove adhering organic matters found in clay. The powder, limestone and water washed clay are sent to flow in the channels and transform or grinding mills where they are completely mixed, and the paste of as slurry. The grinding process can be done in ball or tube mill or even both. Then the slurry is led into collecting basin where composing can be adjusted. The slurry contains around 30 to 40% water that is stored in storage tank and kept ready for the rotary clean. Testing of cement. Testing of cement is done in both field and laboratory in order to analyze its quality characteristic. 1. Fail test. Color. The color of cement should be uniform and gray. B. Physical test. The test is performed to analyze the physical properties of cement. 2. Laboratory test. Fineness test. Fineness of the cement is tested to check the grinding of the cement, which play the direct role influencing the rate of hydration, rate of development of rate of strength and rate of evolution of rate of heat. Fineness of the cement is tested either by sieve test or air permeability test. B. Strength test. Compressive strength. In order to find the compressive strength of cement, prepare the mortar of cement and standard sand in the proportion of 1 having WIC ratio of 0.4 place the motor in the modes of 75 mm and subjected it growing for sufficient during the compressive strength of cube are further tested UTM. Tensile strength of cement or concrete cannot be tested directly. Tensile of strength of cement is computed by preparing the motor as if above test, which is further placed in standard briquettes. Standard consistency test. In order to find initial setting time, final setting time, soundness and strength are parameter termed as standard consistency is fine. Standard consistency is of the cement which permit and preparation of Vickers planer of diameter 10 mm and height 50 mm into the module of the given sample of amount up to depth of 33 to 35 mm from the top and 5 mm to 7 mm from the bottom. This test hence deals with finding the water content at which the cement paste of standard consistency is prepared. In order to perform this test, to take 500 grams cement and added 24 of water by weight in first trial of module. Remove the air void if any found during the preparation of mold. However, the plunger gently up to the top surface of mold and release it quickly. Repeat this rest up till the penetration 33 to 35 mm is observed from the top, and percentage of water at which standard consistency is observed is denoted by P. This test is performed at 24 degrees centigrade and at relative humidity of 90%. Setting time test. This test is used to detect the determine of cement due to storage. The setting time of the cement is generally analyzed in terms of initial and final setting time. Soundness test. It is important that cement after setting does not show any appreciable change in volume as it seriously affected the during of the structure when cement is used in the concrete. Different type of cement. Rapid hardening cement. It is the cement which show the higher rate of development of strength and must not be confused with quick setting cement which only sets quickly. This cement enhances the strength at the age of 3 days, which is equivalent of strength of OPS at 7 days. Extra rapid hardening cement. This cement is manufactured by intergrading rapid hardening click cuts with the calcium chloride percentage which should not be exceed 2% and weight of cement. This cement should be used within 20 meter of its formation. This cement attains 25% higher strength than rapid hardening cement at age 1 to 2 days and 10 to 20 higher strength at the age of 10 days. This gain of strength of cement is reduced at age and at the age of 90 days. Strength of cement is found to be approximately same as the of the OPC. Sulfate resistant cement. OPC is higher susceptible of attack of sulfate, especially to that of MgSO4, which react with both CaOH2 to form CaSO4 and calcium aluminate to form calcium sulfur aluminate, volume of which approximately 2 to 27 than the original volume of the constitute. सुपर सल्फेट सीमेंट, दिस सीमेंट इज मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाय इनर ग्रीन 80% ग्रैनुल्स ब्लास्ट फर्नेस स्लैग विद 15% हार्ड बर्न जिप्सम एंड 5% सीमेंट क्लीनर्स क्लिंकर्स. The Portland slag cement. This cement is produced by integrating cement clinkers with gypsum and granulated blast furnace slag in defined proportion. It is low heat cement, quick setting cement. This cement is produced by adding small percentage of aluminum sulfate and reducing gypsum content and increasing fineness of the cement. Low heat cement. This cement is produced and reducing the proportion CA, C3A and C3S in scarification portion of C2S. The cement develops the strength at very slow rate in generally used massor concreting. Heat hydration of cement of age of 7 days is not greater than 65 calories per gram. At the age of 28 is not greater than 75 kilocalories gram. Portland Plazonala cement. Portland Plazonala cement is prepared by grinding plazonic clinker with Portland cement. It is also produced by adding plazonala with the addition of gypsum or calcium sulfate by intermittently and uniformly blending Portland cement and fine plazonala. This cement has high resistance and various chemical attacks on concrete compared with ordinary Portland cement, and thus it's widely used. It is used in marine structure and sewage work and sewage work for laying concrete underwater as bridge wires, dams, and mass concrete work, etc. High aluminium cement. This cement is manufactured by integrating the clinker obtained from calcination of butoxide and lime. This type of cement percentage of aluminium should not be less than 32%, and ratio of aluminium to lime should be in the range of 0.85 to 1.3. This cement after initial setting time more than 3.5 hours and final setting time for of 5 hours, hence provide more time for placing and finishing. This cement can withstand high temperature and action of acid. The cement attains higher earlier strength such that 20% of ultimate strength and attains on in one day, and substantial strength and attained within 6 to 8 hours. Thank you for your precious time. With regard, Mohsin Jamal sir.